हेलो, आई एम मयूर काळे फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी, एसकेपी कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, कामठी। इन टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन वी विल डिस्कस द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी ऑफ पार्किंसन डिसीज। सो दिस पार्किंसन डिसीज इज अ न्यूरोडिजेनरेटिव डिसीज विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ डिसीज ऑफ बेसल गैंग्लिया, विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू कंट्रोल द मूवमेंट। इन आवर ब्रेन डोपामाइन इज रिलीज बाय थ्री पाथवेज, दैट इज निग्रोस्टियाटल पाथवे, मेसोलिम्बिक मेसोकॉर्टिकल पाथवे एंड टिबेरोहाइपोफाइशियल पाथवे। इन निग्रोस्टियाटल पाथवे डोपामाइन इज रिलीज फ्रॉम सब्सटेंशिया निग्रा टू कॉर्पस स्टार्टम। दिस कॉर्पस स्टार्टम इंक्लूड्स ग्लोबस पैलिडस, कॉर्डेट एंड पुटामिन। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पाथवे डोपामाइन इज एक्ट एज ए इनहिबिटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर फॉर कंट्रोलिंग ऑफ एनी मूवमेंट, वेर एज एसिटाइल कोलिन इज एक्ट एज एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर। अ इनहिबिटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर डोपामाइन रेगुलेटिंग द फंक्शन ऑफ एसिटाइल कोलिन एंड इनहिबिट एक्सेसिव मूवमेंट्स। इन द पार्किंसन डिसीज देर इज अ न्यूरोडिजेनरेशन ऑफ डोपामिन न्यूरोन्स विच लीड्स टू अ लॉस ऑफ इनहिबिटरी इन्फ्लुएंस, दैट इज अ लॉस ऑफ डोपामाइन मेडिएटेड इनहिबिटरी एक्टिविटी एंड लीड्स टू अ एक्साइटेटरी एक्टिविटीज। द सिम्टम्स ऑफ पार्किंसन्स इंक्लूड्स मोटर सिम्टम्स एंड नॉन मोटर सिम्टम्स। दिस मोटर सिम्टम्स इंक्लूड अकाइनेसिया, ट्रीमर्स, रिजिडिटी, पोस्चुरल इंस्टेबिलिटी एंड ब्रैडीकाइनेसिया, वेयर दिस नॉन मोटर सिम्टम्स इंक्लूड ऑटोनॉमिक डिसफंक्शंस, न्यूरोसाइकेट्रिक प्रॉब्लम, स्लीप डिफिकल्टीज। द स्टेजेस ऑफ पार्किंसन डिसीज इंक्लूड स्टेज वन, दैट इज माइल्ड सिम्टम्स अफेक्ट ओनली वन साइड ऑफ द बॉडी। Stage 2, that is symptoms affect both the side of the body with posture and gait changes. Stage 3, that is body movements are slow and the balance is impaired. Stage 4 showing the symptoms which are more severe, the muscles become rigid and the patient can't lie alone and walking is limited. Whereas in the stage 4, a person is completely dependent and the patient needs a constant care. The pathophysiology of Parkinson's disease includes genetic factor, environmental factor, and free radical theory of aging. The genetic factors include dominant inheritance and recessive inheritance. The environmental factor includes synthetic neurotoxin, insecticides, herbicides, and fungicides. So, in the genetic factor, there are two types of factor, that is dominant gene and the recessive gene. Mutation in a group of dominant genes that encoded the alpha synuclein and LRK2 genes are transmitted in the dominant fashion in the Parkinson disease. The SNCA gene, the discovery of mutation in the SNCA gene was the first evidence of the genetic cause of the Parkinson disease. This gene encodes the protein alpha synuclein, the main component of the Lewy body. Mutation of the SNCA gene account for about 2% of the familial cases, though not all persons with these changes have developed Parkinson disease. The mean age of the onset of individual with the mutation in the gene is 46 years. Second is LRRK2 gene, which is formerly known as PARK8 gene, is a signaling protein that becomes toxic when it mutates. The LRRK2 gene encoded for a protein called as dardarin. One segment of the dardarin protein contains a large amount of an amino acid called leucine. A protein with leucine-rich region appeared to play a role in the activities that required interactions with one protein, such as transmitting signal or helping to assemble the cell's structural cytoskeleton. The other part of the dardarin proteins are though to be involved in protein-to-protein interaction. The recessive gene includes the PARK2 or Parkin genes. The PARK2 gene, one of the largest human genes, provided instruction for making a protein called Parkin, which play a role in the breakdown of the unneeded proteins. It does this by tagging damaged and excessive proteins with a molecule called ubiquitins. Ubiquitin serves as a signal to move unneeded proteins into a specialized cell structure called as proteasomes, where the proteins are degraded. The ubiquitin proteasome systems act as the cell's quality control by disposing of damage, mishaps, and excess proteins. This system also regulates the unavailability of proteins that are involved in several critical cell activities, such as the timing of the cell division and growth. Because of its activity, the ubiquitin protease system, parking belongs to a group of protein called as E3 ubiquitin ligase. Second is a pink one, that is a PARC6 gene. More than 70 mutations that can cause Parkinson's disease have been found in the PINK1 gene. Interestingly, when fruit flies carrying PINK1 mutation were given vitamin K2, the energy production in their mitochondria was partly restored and the insect's ability to generate energy to fly was improved. Researchers have been able to determine that the energy production by the restored because of the vitamin K2 had improved electron transport in the mitochondria. This in turn lead to improved adenosine triphosphate and energy production for flight. Vitamin K2 play a role in the energy production of defective mitochondria. Because defective mitochondria are found in some Parkinson's patients, vitamin K2 potentially offers hope for a new treatment for the Parkinson's. And at last, DJ1, that is the PARC7 gene. The PARC7 gene provides instruction for making the DJ1 protein. This protein is found in many tissue and organ, including the brain. One of the protein's function may be to help protect cells, particularly brain cells, for oxidative stress. Next is the environmental factor, that is a synthetic neurotoxin, that is a MPTP, N-methyl-4-phenyl-tetrahydropyridine. Generally, the heroin consume person more prone to the Parkinson's disease because heroin is contaminated with the synthetic neurotoxins. This MPTP will convert it into a MPP free radical by the activity of enzyme monoamine oxidase B. And this MPP free radicals having a more affinity for the nigrostriatal, the neurons of the dopamine present in the nigrostriatal pathway and causing the neurodegeneration and leads to Parkinson's disease. The several other environmental factors responsible for the Parkinson's disease are the insecticide, that is a permethrin or beta hydroxychlorocyclohexane, fungicides MANEB, herbicides paraquat and 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. The last theory for the Parkinson's disease is a free radical theory. A chemical species with unpaired or an odd number of electrons are called as free radical. In the humans, the term free radical mostly refer to the ROS, that is a reactive oxygen species, and oxygen centered. Major ROS include the superoxide anion, hydrogen peroxide, hydroxyl radical. Besides reactive oxygen species, reactive nitrogen species including the nitric oxide and peroxynitrates are contributing the free radicals. Oxygen derived toxicity has been suggested as being involved in the pathogenesis of Parkinson's disease. In humans, a superoxide dismutase which catalyzes the glutathione peroxidase and glutathione reductase provide the enzymatic defense against the oxygen toxicity. With respect to age, there is a decrease in the level of enzyme superoxide dismutase, thus decrease in the engulfing of free radical and leads to an increase in the formation of oxidative free radical, which leads to neurodegeneration. This increase in the oxidative free radical will occur with respect to age in the Parkinson's disease, also called as progressive disease. Okay, so this all from the pathophysiology of Parkinson's disease. Thank you.